Now let us move to the topic of triangles. So in triangles, areas and all were already covered as part of the mensuration course. So here in geometry, we'll specifically keep it to identities and congruences. So when you're talking about two triangles being similar, you have four rules here. One is the SSS rule. So now I'm talking about the SSS rule. So you have two triangles, ABC and PQR. With all three sides of the triangles exactly equal. So then you can say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So which is nothing but you are saying that both these triangles are one and the same. So that is the congruency under SSS rule. Now let us talk about the ASA rule, angle, side and angle. What happens here? In the ASA rule, you are talking about two angles and a side. So how does that work? Again, you are talking about two triangles, ABC and PQR. This angle is equal to this angle. This angle is equal to this angle. And this side is equal. So two angles and the included side. If they are equal, again you can very clearly say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So both these triangles are one and the same. Now let us learn the SAS congruency rule. So under this rule, you are talking about side angle and side. Again, I have my triangle PQR here. This side and this side are same. This side and this side are same. This angle and this angle are same. So again, that will push me to accept the fact that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Because if you are talking about the included angle, which means that this side and this side are equal. So that is inferred. So that is my side angle and side analogy. Now let me move to the RHS case. So this is only applicable for right angle triangles where you are talking about the right angle, hypotenuse and side. So if this is the right angle, so right angle is same irrespective of which triangle it is. A right angle is a right angle, right? So now if the hypotenuse and the side are same for two right angle triangles, ABC and DBF, so you can very clearly say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DBF. So again, they are one and the same. So that is what we are basically talking about. And these three are the different rules for congruency. Now let us talk about centers of a triangle. So what does it mean? I am talking about centroid. Centroid is nothing but the point of intersection of the medians in a triangle. So median is a line drawn from this vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side. So this is the midpoint. Similarly, this is the midpoint. Similarly, this is the midpoint. So my focus is on the midpoints. So whenever this happens, the point of intersection is called a centroid. So G is my centroid. And always remember, the centroid divides the median in the ratio 2:1. Let's say this midpoint is D. So I will say that AG is to GD is nothing but 2:1. So now let me go to the next point, next center in this particular triangle, which is nothing but the in center. So centroid we have covered. In center is nothing but the point of intersection of the angle bisectors. So this line divides the angle X present here into two halves. Similarly, this line divides the angle Y here into two parts. So that is why you call it an angle bisector. Similarly, this divides this angle into two parts. So the point of intersection of all the angle bisectors in a circle, this is called the in center, also denoted by I. So the perpendicular distance from the in center to any side of the triangle, this is called the in radius. So R is nothing but my in radius. So when you are computing area of a triangle, there is one approach where you can calculate it using the in radius also. But it's not very common that you always have your in radius to compute this. So generally we learn it using the formula based method using base, height and semi perimeter. But in case you have it, when you have the in radius, this is one approach where you can use to find the area of the triangle. Next will be circumcenter, which is nothing but the point of intersection of the perpendicular bisectors. So for AB, this is the perpendicular bisector. So which bisects this perpendicularly? For AC, this is the perpendicular bisector. For BC, this is the perpendicular bisector. So the point of intersection of all these perpendicular bisectors is my circumcenter. Correct? Now, let me talk about the last one, which is the orthocenter. So in your triangle, you just drop a perpendicular from A to BC. Same from B to AC. So this is nothing but the height. So all these perpendiculars that you're dropping from these respective points indicate nothing but the height of the triangle. So the point of intersection of all these altitudes of a triangle from different vertices, this is my orthocenter. Orthocenter is nothing but all the altitudes that you have drawn, whatever point they coincide, this point is your orthocenter.